Hello and welcome to Education Express, my dear friends. Today's class is a very special class because it is not about a particular topic. It is not even about a particular method or such. Here, what we are going to discuss today is basically the principles of unlocking a mathematical language. In the past few years, I have come across many students and realize that they have a fear for solving word problems. Most of them are resorting to learning, memorizing a word problem rather than applying their analyzing skills. Mathematical is a universal subject based on the universal principles. In spite of a rigid and a very logical subject, yet the fear in the mind of students with respect to word problem has been noticed almost in all the phases. Here is an attempt by means of which I have tried to make their life little more simple, comfortable, smooth, and definitely more interesting, more enriching, with helping them explore and evolve in mathematics. Myself, Kishore Jain, working with various colleges as a visiting faculty as well as teaching students for the past 27 years and understanding and reading the mind of the students, have come to a point wherein I felt like sharing this video so that it can be genuinely helpful to all the students as well as the parent at large who can help their kids understand the basic concepts involved in solving and unlocking word problem. So I'm going to share with you a few of the tricks which will help you understand the mathematics very easily. Of course, in between I may probably be compelled to use English language so that my other audience can also have an opportunity of understanding what exactly I'm trying to say. So there are few keywords. Whenever you come across word problems, there are few caveats. There are few assumptions that should always be kept in your mind. I'll give you a simple example with respect to the assumptions. When you're talking about, let us say, solving a word problem which are based on ages. Father is so many years elder to the son, or the ratio of the ages of the two brothers, or the ratio of ages of A and B, or something like that. Make sure that whenever you're making a choice for making an assumption, ensure that between the two brothers, assume the age of younger brother as X. Of course, you can always make a choice and choose the elder brother also as an X, but just to make your life more comfortable, more uniform, to form a solution without having any kind of negativity, it would always be advisable to follow this test. Between the two numbers, the smaller and the greater, make sure that smaller number is assumed to be an X. Between the length and the breadth of a rectangle, whenever you're making a choice, make sure that you are taking the smaller of the length or a breadth assumed to be an X. Besides that, listen to me carefully how a word problem needs to be interpreted. Now, whenever you will read word problem, there are some keywords which has a very special meaning in mathematics. Those keywords are not too many, but they are too little. But the usage in word problem would surely be there. A word problem is not possible to be constructed without the use of those keywords. And if you focus on these keywords, and if you know how to make an application of those keywords, then this chapter will not only help you to construct the questions which are based on linear equation with one variable, linear equation with two variables, quadratic equations, and many questions which are based on straight lines, coordinate geometry, so on and so forth. In fact, entire algebra part, even geometry for that matters, wherever word problem would be there, you will definitely have an edge by knowing and interpreting those words. So what are those magic words of mathematics? The magic word of mathematics is, try and look out for the word is, are, was, be, and sometimes not so active. This word is not so active, but they are the very active words. Is, are, was, be should be equated to equal to sign. Remember, my friends, when I am introducing this to you, right now you will not be able to understand what exactly this will transpire into. But once actually we'll sit to start doing the questions on word problem, this will surely be an oxygen for you. And it will help you to build your confidence. There are few more from the gallery of all those words. The magic words would be, is, are, was, be, and sometimes by also, which would mean equal to. Whenever you see the word some, more, greater, my dear friends, understand that this has only one meaning, which is plus. It's very simple to say so, but when it comes to apply it, of course, even you will find it a bit resistance in the initial stage. But once you get the confidence of getting the answers by interpreting these words and applying them in the questions, you guys are going to rock after that. Of course, when it says a sum more greater, so we say smaller, lesser, or less, everyone knows it would be minus. When I say product, when I say times, it should mean multiplication. My dear friends, these are a very, very simple way of interpreting a word problem. I will discuss with you many such word problems by making a set of usage of these words only. When I will apply, you see in what sense I am applying the keywords to extract my solution to frame a word problem into a simple equation. Most importantly, is, are, was, be, by would be substituted by equal to. Some, more, greater, plus, smaller, lesser, less, minus, product, times, multiplication. Besides that, we had been struggling to solve the questions based on age problems. So whenever we say that 5 years after 5 years, 5 years hence, or 5 years from now, you know what does it mean? When I used to say 5 years hence, or after 5 years, or from now, 5 years hence, from now, after, it would mean plus. And when I say ago or before, it would mean minus. Finally, two more keywords. It says, whenever it says A exceeds B, or if I say X exceeds Y, it means X minus Y. My dear friends, X exceeds Y would mean X minus Y, the difference between the two. And lastly, by default, the younger one would always be chosen as X. The smaller number should have been chosen as X by default. That will make the life more comfortable, more easy, which will help us bypass some of the complex calculation if we adopt this and start taking the younger of the two number, the smaller of the two number, the younger of the two brothers as X. As it is, we have to make an assumption for both A and B. In case if A is younger, ensure that you have chosen A as X and B as whatever the condition of the question may be. Appropriately, when you note down these words, when you start applying these words in the word problem, I can give you an assurance that most of the word problems will start unlocking by themselves. It becomes very, very simple. one more KBA, last and final. So far what you need to remember, you need to remember the following thing. सर जब भी वर्ड प्रॉब्लम आएगा तो मुझे क्या करना है. सो जब भी वर्ड प्रॉब्लम आएगा आपको इन वर्ड्स की खोज करनी है उस वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स में से. कोई भी वर्ड प्रॉब्लम इन शब्दों के बिना बन ही नहीं सकते हैं. इट इज प्रैक्टिकली नॉट पॉसिबल टू मेक अ वर्ड प्रॉब्लम विदाउट दिस वर्ड्स. कहीं पे भी व्हेन यू कम अक्रॉस इज आर वॉज बी और बाय आपको उसके बदले में इक्वल टू से रिप्लेसमेंट करना है. रिमेंबर कोई भी इक्वेशन 2x minus 7y equals to 11 plus 4x, 7x plus 2 equals to 9 minus 3x, ऐसा कोई भी इक्वेशन हो, equal to आने के बाद, remember, जब भी मैं ये वर्ड का इस्तेमाल करूंगा और मेरे वर्ड्स में जब भी शब्दों में ये equal to आ गया, तो एक बार equal to आने के बाद, जो भी explanation, जो भी condition question में दी है, उन सबका ऑपरेशन आपको ये बाजू ही करना है, ये बाजू नहीं करना है. ये आपको तब पता चलेगा जब मैं एक्चुअली सम्स आपके सामने करूंगा. आई एम श्योर दैट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड मोर ऑन इट व्हेन आई एक्चुअली डू द सम्स. सो एज फार एज रूल्स आर कंसर्न्ड यू आर वेरी मच फैमिलियर विद द रूल्स. नाउ इट्स टाइम फॉर अस टू सी इफ दिस रूल्स व्हेन अप्लाइड राइटली डज इट गिव्स अस the expected results. Here we go. After going through all the keywords that we have stated before, now you would be interested in knowing whether those words, keywords, are genuinely a magic word which can help us relieve from the word problems fiasco. The answer is absolutely yes. Here we go. I'll be providing you a sheet of 10 questions enclosed with this video. The question so far I would be doing is an age problem. Please may have your attention please on this question. It says, it read as, Robert's father is 4 times as old as Robert. So it says, Robert's father is 4 times as old as Robert's. Robert's father is 4 times as old as Robert's age. So basically, when you read the first line of your word problem, it says Robert's father is 4 times as old as Robert. Robert being a younger between the two, I would say Robert and father. I would say let the age, or you can say present age, present age of Robert be X years. As we discussed earlier also, between the two, whoever is younger, we will take the age of younger as X. Robert's father, we don't know. Is, sir, is means equal to. 4, as I told you, after equal to, every operation, every single thing will come on the other side, not this side. It got punctuated. Is 4 times as old as Robert. Robert is how much? So if the present age of the Robert is X, father would be 4X. Wonderful. That means we could translate our first line. Robert's father is 4 times as old as Robert. So we could simply say that father is keyword, 4 times keyword multiplication as old as Robert. We got it. What is the next line? It says further. Let us see what it says. Yeah. It further states that after five years. Father would be after 5 years. So we have after in age problem. So after 5 years, as we have hinted that after 5 years, after would be plus. So earlier I was X, now I would be X plus 5. Father was 4X. So at the same time, father would be 4X plus 5. Now they say that after 5 years, Father. After 5 years, father. Father. Will be. Will be. Is, are, was, be. Be, 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 be. So, after 4 years, or after 5 years, sorry, after 5 years, this is a father's age. Father. Will be. Further. Three times. Three times. As old as Robert. As old as Robert. So, my dear friends, don't you think every single magic word that we have spoken about was used while unlocking a word problem? It stated that Robert's father, that means father, is, four times, times, as old as Robert. So this is done. Present age X and 4X. Then it says after 5 years. So after 5 years means after plus. So age of Robert will become X plus 5. Age of father will become 4X plus 5. After 5 years, father's age. After 5 years, father's age will be 3 times as old as Robert. As old as Robert. So my dear friends, these questions can be solved very, very simple way. You shift this 3x on this side. 4x minus 3x equals to 15 minus 5. Therefore, x equals to 15 minus 5, 10 years. That means if you look over here, Robert must be 10 year old and father, whose 4x, would be 40 year old. I'm not going much into the solving aspect of word problem. I'm only here to teach you how to unlock the word problem and to translate into an equation. So this is how we have translated a word problem into an equation. Of course, yes, every time we have followed one rule, that means the rule of using our keywords. Let us move on to the next question. Question number 8 from the same sheet. Question number 8. What it says? 7 times the number. I don't know which number. So I am saying, let the number be X. So they are saying, 7 times the number. 7 times number. Is means equal to. 7 times the number is. So the question is, 7 times the number is 36 less than 10 times the number. This is what is mentioned in the question, saying that 7 times the number, so 7 times the number is, so I put is, 36 less. My dear friend, check out, lesser, less, smaller means minus. So I have to subtract 36. So I am subtracting 36. Minus 36. As I told you, once you get the punctuation of is, are, was, be, all the operations will happen on the other side. That means to your right hand side. Nothing on the left hand side. 7 times a number is 36 less. 36 less. Then, 10 times the number. What would be 10 times the number? So, 10 times the number would be 10 into X. 7 times the number is 36 less. 36 less than? 36 less than 10 times the number. So, my dear friends, 7X equals to 10X minus 36. Can we shift this 36 on the other side? Of course. 7 on that side. So, 10X minus 7X. That gives you 3x equals to 36, and of course x equals to 12. Objective is not to solve this, for me at least, objective is to frame this. This can be managed by the student, importantly how to frame it right. If you want to verify, you can verify also. If the number was x, what would be 7 times the number? Sir, 7 times the number would be 84. Absolutely right. Then they are saying that, from the 10 times number, what was the number? 12. If you subtract 36, what you will get? 84. Yes sir, these both are correct. So 7 times a number is 36 less than 10 times a number. My dear friend,
I'm sure slowly and gradually your faith will build in this kind of words. This question wasn't that simple. Many students make mistake in writing 7x minus 36 equals to 10x. The whole question will go wrong. What is more important over here is to know where to punctuate. When I say 7 times a number, 7 times a number is, that means I am punctuating here is. Now nothing can come on the other side. If at all there is any operation, it has to come on the other side. So that's the reason I give. Less, the moment you get less means you have to subtract. How much? So 36 less, so you have to subtract 36. From what? 10 times a number, 10 times a number. So let's move on to the next question. Question number 9 from the same sheet. Now when I read question number 9, what it reads is, Rene is 6 years older than her younger sister. So basically the name of the younger sister is not given in the question, but it says that Rene is 6 years older than her younger sister. So Rene and younger sister. So younger sister. I don't know the age of the younger sister or Rene either. But I only know one thing. Rene is 6 years older than her younger sister. So can I assume that let the present age of the younger sister be X? Because as we discussed and decided that the age of the younger person would always be assumed to be an X. Younger number or the smaller number or the lesser number will always be assumed to be an X by default. That is what has been the premise on which we started making such assumptions. Between the two, Rene and the younger sister, it's mentioned that Rene is 6 years older. Rene is 6 years older. So if the sister, younger sister is X, Rene would be X plus 6. Sir, why like that? If you are 10 and you are younger to me by 6 years, then my age would be 10 plus 6. So whatever is the age of sister, I would be 6 years older, to plus 6. So we know the present age of Rene and younger sister. See what are the conditions given, alright? After 10 years, that means 10 years after. Now what is after stands for? Sir, after means plus. So it says whatever it was given, the old age, add to that 10. What was the age? Sir, X. Add to that 10. So what it will come up to? Sir, this would be X plus 16. This would be X plus 10. The question was very simple. It was given to us. There are two characters in the question. Rene and the sister. It was given that Rene is older. Older than the sister. We don't know the age of the sister. So we decided that whoever is younger, whoever is smaller in case of numbers, we always presume that or assume that to be X. So I've chosen let the present age of younger sister be X. If sister is X, Rene is 6 years older. So X plus 6. Remember my dear friends, people who don't know math, people who really don't understand much of math, I have seen among few of my students also the type of mistakes that they commit. When I say 6 years older, they multiply by 6. Remember, if it is 6 years older, that means I am elder to you by 6 years. So my age compared to your age is 6 more. So in case if you are X, then Rene would be X plus 6. I hope this is understood. After 10 years, so we have chosen and added after 10 years. What is the condition given to us? The condition is after 10 years, the sum of the ages of Rene and her younger sister would be 50. So after 10 years, the sum of their ages, this and this, sum means what? So sum means plus. So sum of their ages, sum of their ages is 50 years. X plus X, 2X equals to 50. 2X, can I take 26 on the other side? Of course, sir. So 2x equals to 24, x equals to 12. So you got to know the age of younger sister, which is 12, whereas age of Renee, 12 plus 6, that's going to be 18 years old. So my dear friends, let's move on to the next question. The next question. It says, a man is twice as old as his son. A man is twice as old as his son. This is a starting statement. 12 years ago, what it says? 12 years ago, the man was 3 times as old as his son. A man was 3 times as old as his son. Find their present age. So, this is a word problem. It says a man is twice as old as his son. So we have a father and a son. Can I say, let the present age of son, because son is younger. So son, let the present age of the son be X years. So we know that the age of the son is X years. Start. A man, that is a father, is means equal to twice as old as his son. Son is X. So if son is X, father would be 2X. We got the present age of son and the father. I hope you understand the importance of the word is. Twice. Then what it says, 12 years ago. So 12 years ago. Can you tell me what would be the age of father? Son, ago. Ago means minus. So it will be 2x minus 12. What about son? So son would be x minus 12. So we have the ages 12 years ago. What was father's age? So this much. What was son's age? So x minus 12. So what it says, 12 years ago, a man, that is this man, was. So punctuate it equal to 3 times as old as his son. As old as his son. So this becomes your equation. We can easily solve this equation. 3x minus 3 into 12, 36. Can we take this 2x on the other side? Of course, sir. 3x minus 2x. This minus 36, when comes on this side, it will become 36 minus 12. 3x minus 2x will give you x. 36 minus 12 will give you 24. So that means son is 24 year old, whereas father would be 48 year old. Every time we are making use of the keywords, not just keywords, but the magical words of mathematics, which is helping us to solve our question. Let us move on to the next one. So my dear friends, let us experiment the same thing on the two questions which has been listed above. The first one, 20 is 12 less than 4 times a number. Too complicated. 28 is 12 less than 4 times a number. Find the number. But if you use the properties, what I have listed, those magical words, things becomes very simple. See how. 28. Is means equal to. Now you cannot write anything on this side. All operation will happen on the right hand side. Is 12 less. So please subtract 12. Less. Lesser. Smaller. Decrease. All have the same meaning. Minus. So 28 is 12 less than 4 times a number. 4 times. What was the number? We don't know. So let the number be X. Now you need 28 is 12 less than 4 times a number. We don't know. Let the number be X. 4 times x. What is the actual solution? 28 equals to 4x minus 12. Can we shift this 4 minus 12 on the other side? 28 plus 12 equals to 4x. 40 equals to 4x. Therefore, x equals to 10. Find the number. Therefore, a number will be 10.
So guys, I'm sure you will be convinced with the idea that these keywords are really a magic words. As you keep on exploring maths by making use of these keywords, I'm sure scientifically you will develop a different attitude of making the right choice with respect to your words and correctly punctuating them so that it helps you to give you a refined solution. This video was merely an attempt to help you to build a confidence in all of you with respect to decoding of mathematical language. Thank you so much for watching the video. This question number 2 is meant for the audience to solve by themselves. By now, you will surely be ready with all the keywords at your fingertips to make use and its application in your word problems. Till then, goodbye, take care yourself. Thank you so much for watching the video.